quarter four holiday special for you. We're here for you. I got my man on the line with me. Really dope music. Four Horsemen, Hollywood, Alec. What is good,
yeah,
brother? Glad
back,
to have
man.
You back.
We back, man. We doing it big, just like I told you we would, man. Straight up. We're doing it live. You know what I'm saying? Bigger than ever, better than ever. You dig? We got more stories, man. Look. Oh my gosh. It's been off the chain, bro. More FUI reports. More FUI. More of the best stories from the FUI King himself, man. And look, we're going straight into it, dude.
Yes,
it is. Ridiculous. We have the resurgence of our good friend. Unbelievable.
Both of them are back.
Oh, my gosh.
Both of them are back. Pipes is never his music now. And the FUI King do what he does.
Oh, my God. Like, are we serious? Like, this is it? I mean, look, just check out. I just want to go back over this headline that you sent me. And I got to admit, like, when I saw it, it was a jaw-dropping moment. Like, I thought that I was hallucinating or something like that. Like, maybe the joke was on me. You know what I'm saying? Maybe I was getting punked or something, and I was expecting Ashton Kutcher to open up my bedroom door and be like, hey, you know what this is? I mean, headline, adult entertainer and renowned musician Wesley Pipes is re-releasing his classic hits in a Built for Christmas stocking stuffer mixtape featuring songs such as the Grammy Award winning Tag Team Cousins. Right. And I'm with the business.
We covered this five years ago in October. It's been 5 years since we covered this for the first time.
Dude.
And he's back with it again.
You can't make this stuff up. Like, I'm serious. Like, you can't. You just can't. You can't make this stuff up. Like, I mean, let me get it straight, okay? I respect this hustle. Okay? It's the holidays, man. I feel like giving credit. You know what I'm saying? I respect the hustle. I respect the game. Tag Team Cousins. Again. I don't know, man. And that I'm with the business. I was just like, dude. When I saw the video, I was like, man. This has to be like novelty or something. Or maybe they were practicing.
We hope.
I mean.
Or not.
I'm going with the latter. You know what I'm saying? But it was just an amazing thing to see. So, hey, man. Just like I said, dude, do your thing. You know, Merry Christmas.
You know,
because I'm gonna have to pass on that, Chief. That's real.
Yeah, I'm not giving that for a gift. Not at all. Any of y'all listeners buy that mixtape, I'm clowning y'all for life.
Well, I mean, just send us a review or something. I mean, it's all good. You know, I'll listen. Or whatever. Hey, check. Can y'all hear this? Can they hear that?
Barely.
Okay. Could you hear that?
Barely. You was turning up the volume over here on in the studio side. Okay. But you wants to hear? You trying to play Tag Team Cousins or with the business?
Dude, Hey, man, you know, I'm going to pass.
Yeah. It's not worth us buying that. That, my God, my God.
I'm pretty sure that we're going to have a numerous amount of listeners who are going to buy the stocking stuffer. And we know why.
They're after you, just like you.
You understand? That's why we do this show. We, you know, we got to, you know, we got to give the, you know, the credit to where credit is due. And since FUI do the most, you know what I'm saying? We're gonna put you out there. We're gonna let you know that we appreciate you, because it's because of you and the goofy stuff that you pull off that we're even able to do this show. Mm-mm-mm. So,
amen. Hey.
So it's all good. What else? We got a FUI King Material Alert. That means stories, and we got plenty of them. We got plenty of them. What do you think about his latest antics, brother?
They're out of control. And the Cavs have sent him home now. He's not even with the team anymore. He's at home.
Unbelievable.
He wants to be traded away.
Yeah, I was
doing LeBron James in LA, but it ain't happening.
Nah.
LeBron's through with you, bro.
Yeah, I mean, can you blame him?
You can't. I mean, he pulled off.
Well, nobody really wants to be continuously associated with somebody who's just versed in FUI behavior.
Not at all.
You know, so, you know, LeBron is a brand, you know what I'm saying? He's a winner. And, you know, I think there comes a time where you just get tired of the shenanigans. Just do. What is this? J.R. Smith responds to chances of Knicks signing Kyrie Irving. Send me that story. Hi. Okay. According to NBC Sports, Kyrie Irving is reportedly the Knicks' top target in the 2019 free agency. Now, we leave the Celtics for New York. His former Cavaliers teammate J.R. Smith apparently thinks so.
And how would he even know?
According to this network, Irving reportedly told the Cleveland teammates of his desire to join the Knicks, but that was while he was on a team he clearly wanted off. Now that he's in Boston, his plans definitely could have changed. That's what they say. And maybe Smith is going off some shenanigan information. I don't know. Time will tell. We got a lot of stories about, what is this? J.R. Smith is shirtless. J.R. Smith gets shirtless. The Browns win first game since 2016. And I had a chance to review the video, and let me tell you, it's what we would all expect from this guy. He's a definite shenanigan pole. Chilling up there. Chilling up there with LeBron. Dude, come on, man. Shirtless. Well, all right. Don't even want to see that video.
No, you don't.
Okay, we got a connect from Bossip. Let me see what this is. Yeah. All right. Are you kidding?
Yeah, nah, they
not. Wait a minute. So you mean to tell me this is disturbing? Like, you mean to tell me? Man, look. J.R. Smith released a children's book.
Yes, he did.
Are we for real? And, like, is this for real? Okay, according to Bossip, the NBA star released a children's book on Tuesday with his brother, Chris, who are pictured here with tattoos and all, with three little kitties. Okay. Hoop Smith, JR, and Chris learn teamwork, which seemed like a beautiful sentiment until the internet got a hold of the news. I'll drink Henny in a bar. I'll drink Henny in my car. Yeah, that's funny. Okay. Children's book with his brother Chris. Yeah, well, I guess just like the headline says, anything is readable.
Anything is readable.
Anything. All right, man. That is absolutely crazy. What is your... tell me what you think about that, dude. A children's book by the FUI King.
He's trying to breed his own FUI nation by influencing little kids to follow his steps.
Oh, God.
And he's been going around different cities reading these books to children on the book tour while he's been working the gaps.
You gotta be kidding.
Nah, I wish I was. He's providing kids with knowledge. He said that they can't get anywhere with him. He's trying to contribute to the community in a positive way by giving kids the knowledge on an experienced statement person, what he said. An entrepreneur, basketball player, and businessman, an avid golfer, and father and husband, J.R. Swish.
Statement player.
Yes.
Okay. We're only 13 minutes in. And a lot of what we've just seen by itself is just, dude, like, it's shake my head. You know, I mean, that makes me cringe almost. But, you know, just like I said, you know, you got to give credit to where credit is due. These guys are hustling and they want to do things. And, you know, and he wants to be shirtless and do the thing with pipes and write children's books. You know what I'm saying? Add that to the list.
Next? Pipes, children's book? What's next?
A J.R. Swish wrestling game.
Man.
It's not even basketball. Just, I'm a character wrestling.
Exactly.
You know what
he
I'm
is
saying?
A wrestling character. He really is.
Oh, my gosh. Like,
I think he's more of a face than he is a heel.
Could be. Or maybe he's like an anti-hero. Like, I don't want to put him with the likes of Stone Cold Steve Austin or anything like that. But, you know, maybe Raven or something.
And he plans more books for children too. That's what we also said.
Or some weird character. I don't know. Name something.
The Boogeyman. Brodus Clay.
Right. Who else? What's this other guy's name?
Juventud Guerrero.
Somebody like Carlito or something. Like, you don't know if they're good or bad. They're just there.
Exactly. Yes, yes.
Jeez. Anyway, what is this right here? This is... Oh! This is a good one. This is a good one. J.R. Smith has Supreme tattoo, and the NBA might fine him if he doesn't cover it up. And he says, so I was informed today that I would be fined every game if I don't cover up my Supreme tattoo on my leg during games. These people in the league office are something else. They've got a whole brand on your leg chilling.
He's a marketer too now, I see.
You understand? Like, let's keep that clear. It's a brand. I mean, why would you do that? It's a brand that you apparently love. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you put it right on your calf for a reason. You ain't going to be wearing calf socks or nothing like that. You want it to be seen. And I mean, is there, I know they have some guidelines in the league.
Yeah. You have to wear NBA sanctioned branding, like Nike.
Right.
You can't wear your own stuff. You got to be Nike apparel, NBA apparel on the
right.
Court.
Right. And people are going to see it. I mean, when I saw it, you know, I wasn't too familiar with it. But after I saw it, I looked it up. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So if I'm doing that, I mean, so it is a form of marketing. So it is what it is, brother. Yes, it is. Okay. You got anything to say about that anyway?
Man, what I say, this is Smith. I give him credit for his FUI-ism. His shenanigans he pulls, he tries to make money off of them. You notice how our shenanigans are kind of money-based shenanigans? You notice that lately? With the Hennessy endorsement after he made that horrible play, they've been clowning him on social media with the memes. He turned into a Hennessy endorsement deal. He's
right.
The Cavs, the statement player. He's writing books. He did the Back in the Pack, did the album with Pipes and the Supreme. Notice he has a pattern of making business decisions and business moves with FUI shenanigans.
And I mean, it's like I'm not. It's not like we're knocking his hustle, but we do have an opinion, and we can weigh in on the shenanigans. I mean, they're borderline. They're just kind of ridiculous. You know what I'm saying? They're just kind of out. It's almost as if you think that he would know better, or he would use better judgment. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
But that's almost like that's not a part of his own marketing strategy. You dig what I'm saying?
Exactly.
It's just kind of sad that he has to resort to being an FUI to pull this off. So, yeah, I mean, and you know, I have this article up. According to NBC Sports, our good partners and friends, he says he'll cover the Supreme tattoo, but he won't talk to the NBA. I don't talk to the police. Right, you understand what I'm saying?
Exactly.
That's what I'm talking about. Cavalier star J.R. Smith expressed plenty of dismay with being told he'd get fined for each game he doesn't cover his Supreme tattoo, but he's backing down and will cover the leg tattoo. Yeah. Smith, I'm not giving them money that could go to my kids, Smith told ESPN. I looked into my rights, but the Players Association just texted me, and you know what? I'm not going to put money in their pockets. Not a chance. Really? Now, Chris Vidor of Cleveland.com said J.R. Smith said he has to contact the league regarding the Supreme tattoo on his right calf, and they asked him to cover it up. And he doesn't plan on having that conversation. No, for what? He asked when approached by Cleveland.com in the locker room at the Garden in Boston Tuesday night. I don't talk to police. That doesn't do anything for me.
this guy.
I don't talk to police. That doesn't do anything for me. Other than... oh, gosh. This is crazy. Okay. Nah, it says, unfortunately for Smith, the collective bargaining agreement is pretty clear. Other than as may be incorporated into his uniform, the manufacturer's identification incorporated into his sneakers, a player may not, during any NBA game, display any commercial, promotional, or charitable name, mark, logo, or other identification, including but not limited to on his body, in his hair, or otherwise. There it is. In black and white. So, in essence, will Mr. Smith continue his shenanigans with Nichols and Bats the Belfry? Only time will tell. Because he is what he is and he cannot help himself. He is the FUI king. And in today's time, that's a pretty sad thing to be. But that doesn't even stop. With his shenanigans, there's even more.
Exactly.
There's even more. Ladies and gentlemen, for J.R. Smith will pay fans $600 for throwing and breaking a cell phone. Did you hear what I said? I said, Mr. Smith will pay and $600 for throwing and breaking a cell phone. Now, this guy will pay a fan who accused Smith of grabbing, throwing, and breaking his phone. I don't know what's going on with this guy. I don't know what's going on. It's sad. Now he's breaking cell phones. So in other words, you're being a bully. Is that safe to say?
Yes, he was.
Well, I you know what I'm saying? I could imagine that this guy was probably terrified as he grabbed his cell phone for doing something people probably always do when they're surrounded by their favorite, you know, basketball stars or, sports star, whatever. They break out a cell phone and they want to take pictures or whatever. So he will have to pay $600 in restitution to reimburse this 20-year-old admirer from Pennsylvania who stopped to take the ex-Knicks photo on 10th Ave near West 18th Street around 2:30 a.m. on July 29th. You dig what I'm saying? That's just what I was saying.
Totally FUI. You know,
right. He is just like the... I'm sure he knows his behavior will make the news. You understand?
But he's in a live stream right now saying that we're lying on him.
Deceptions. Unbelievable. You're an unbelievable guy. But it's okay. We respect your hustle anyway. Right? Yeah. Whatever.
Yes, we do. Takes a special man to club shenanigans that he pulls.
Oh, my gosh. It's just unbelievable. Okay. Now, what other stories do we have? Another J.R. Smith report? Okay, here we go.
Yeah, a lot of them.
We got a bunch, dude. It's ridiculous. I'm trying to sift through it now.
In Hollywood, I remember you say all the time, Hollywood, we could do a whole hour on him easily without even trying.
It's ridiculous. Okay, what is this? Okay, J.R. Smith considered leaving Cavaliers after they again pulled him from rotation.
Mm-hmm.
He go with that. This ought to be really interesting. This picture is ridiculous. according to NBC Sports, J.R. Smith considered leaving Cavaliers after they pulled him pulled him from rotation. Now, first of all, why would they want to do that? I wonder.
They're tanking.
Would you like to elaborate on that? They're tanking.
The Cavs are trying to lose on purpose.
All right.
And playing J.R. Smith does not help them lose on purpose. This is the one occasion he's not really been in FUI. The one occasion. And your brother, you can feel free to read the story because, you know, it has some FUI activity in what that story says by Dan Feldman, a bunch of hours here on the Boss Man Show.
That's right. That's right. Well, you know, sometimes that's the way it is. Just for the second time this season, Smith would be informed he would be removed from the rotation. And not receive guaranteed playing time. Unbelievable. Smith was upset by that news and considered taking some time away from the team. Yep. Smith decided to stay for the time being. This guy's amazing. Oh, good old buddy. Hey, man. Well, what can you say from a guy who does a song with pipes?
Exactly.
I don't know.
He has a job off doing a song with pipes.
Dude, come on, man. Oh, this is funny. Chance of Smith's name echoed through the mostly vacated arena late in the fourth quarter as fans wanted Smith to get some playing time. It never happened. Smith
wow.
was one of two players not to see action. Channing Frye was the other. Woo-hoo-hoo. Dude. Okay. What is this? You sent me something. Oops, hype. Also, sources close to Smith have said he will not ask for or accept a buyout. So this is how it's going to be for Smith and the Cavs this season. They'll stay married with their eyes elsewhere. In the meantime, trying to get along. I just love reading it, man. This stuff is just hilarious, dude. This stuff is hilarious. Okay, you sent me that. I got that. You have me the Cavaliers are tanking. Got that. Okay, let's see this right here. G.R. Smith and the Cavaliers have mutually agreed for him to leave the team as both sides work to find a trade, the team announced. And that was on the 20th. Oh, man. I can't wait till we get to these emails. Oh!
They're pathetic.
This is pathetic. Pro Football Talk. Cordarrelle Patterson caught grabbing Henry Anderson's crotch.
FUI.
We're adding him to the list, dude. Hey, man. Hey, first of all, oh, man, this is incredible. This guy. His name is Cordarrelle. Cordarrelle.
It's like a bad corduroy brand of clothing.
That's what I was thinking about. Like on a serious note. That's exactly what I was thinking. I thought that was it sounds like the name brand of a less expensive corduroy jean.
That Ron Zombie would wear.
Like you could buy it in Walmart.
And worn by Ron Zombie. Oh, Ascot wearer himself.
He's going to be the first one. He's going to be the first one. He's gonna have, and he's gonna have the jacket. You know, the court. He's gonna have like the corduroy jacket with the suede with the suede elbow.
The suede elbow.
I had an umbrella with frills on it, fretting it and stuff.
And his Dollar General Dollar Tree ascot he's gonna get too with his
oh my
ass
god. That's unbelievable. Yeah, that I mean, you know, it's kind of funny. Yep, but according to what is this? PFT?
Yeah, that's PFT. It?
Okay. Patriots wide receiver Cordarrelle Patterson made himself quite familiar with Jets defensive lineman Henry Anderson during that Sunday's 27-13 win. Okay. CBS cameras caught Patterson grabbing Anderson's crotch.
God.
While Anderson was kneeling over him at the end of a play. Anderson went down before the camera moved elsewhere, but the move caught the attention of Anderson's fiance, and Patterson was asked to explain what happened after the game. I'm a grown man, Patterson said via Connor Orr of Sports Illustrated. I don't need one's I don't need one's asking something and something else.
Got him balls in his face, huh?
In my face. There. Okay. So. So to make matters worse, you're gonna grab it?
Exactly.
There was no penalty called on Patterson, but he could receive a fine if the league thinks he went a bit too far in his attempt to get out from under Anderson. Is this is this for real?
These guys are tripping.
Dude, really?
Thanks.
I think
he's joining the list.
I think it was consensual. That's what I think. The FURs are out tonight. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, that set me for a loop, my darn self.
Yeah. It made me cringe.
Dude, okay.
I don't need no joker to grab my Johnson on the football field.
Dude, you know, you would just, I don't know, maybe you would just think that he would have, like, maybe punched him in the leg or maybe tried to kick him.
Something.
You know, something, but they said he just grabbed, like, he grabbed it. Grab is grab.
Sick.
I don't know about that, though. That's just weird. That's weirdly behavior. But anyway, Giannis, what the heck? Pro basketball park? Did you send me this? Giannis?
Yeah.
And to... That sounds like something that we read on our email.
Exactly! A terrible name!
Antetokounmpo?
Yes, yeah, something like that. Antetokounmpo. Yeah.
On saying he punched Mario Hezonja in his nuts. What I said, what the heck is going on with this, man?
Exactly.
Man, dude, like,
these guys are tripping.
I mean, why would I say what I said, but I've got to choose better words. I mean, how are you going to put that?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? I'd punch him in the balls?
Exactly.
I'd punch him. You know, I'd punch him in his scrotum. There's no good way to put that. There's no better words that you could, you know, there. I mean, what are you going to say? I'd punch
exactly.
him in, man, I really want to punch him in the nan.
Want to hit him in his jingle bells.
I mean, for real, like.
Hey, there's no good way to decode that.
Right, there's no good way, there's no better words that you could put in that. I want to, what are you going to say? He wants to give him a low blow? That's even suspect. But anyway, dude, he's going to punch. And what's up with it? Even here, said Knicks forward Mario has on your dunk with Giannis and something. Defending him, then stepped over the Bucks star. And then he said he was going to punch him in the nuts next time. Well, you know, he said that he wants to be a better role. He wants to be a role model for a lot of kids, and he has to choose better words, man. Maybe just don't say nothing. There's nothing else. There's no better way to, you know, to put that. And just the fact that you said you meant it, I mean, you meant it.
Yeah.
You meant it. And I believe him. But, you know, I don't know what's going on with all the, you know, giving all this attention to the to balls.
Exactly.
Yeah, one guy grabbing balls and we got this other guy. He wants to punch the guy on the ball.
These guys are all FUIs right now. The NBA, the NFL.
Yeah, they're just, y'all are doing too much. Y'all need to calm down. You know what I'm saying? And don't talk about the crotches. Don't be trying to hit nobody in the balls, man. All right. Here's another one right here. He's about to make the list. Yes, indeed. Our good friend. Okay, Patrick Beverly was fined $25,000. For throwing a ball at a Mavericks fan. Now, why would he want to do that?
Why would he do that?
Oh, I guess this is why. It says, during the Clippers' loss to the Mavericks, a Dallas fan insulted Patrick's mother with profanity, according to Beverly. But this other guy, the guy who insulted Patrick's mother allegedly, said that he didn't use profanity. But I think one thing can be taken into account. Somebody said something about somebody's mama.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know, man. I think Mr. Beverly might get a pass on this one. Because you can say anything you want to say. But don't talk about no black person mama, man.
Exactly.
You're going to get the business. And I'm talking no pipes. Just
no
business,
pipes.
Period. Said, so he took matters into his own hands and threw the ball. You know what I'm saying? And he got ejected. And now he's going to get fined $25,000. And I don't know, you know, there's a good question on this article being asked, and it said, what's the consequence for a fan?
You know, nothing.
Of course, you know what I'm saying? You know, and I understand, like, when you're on the court, you're playing, you know what I'm saying, you're doing your thing, and, the game could get heated, you know, it gets intense. And somebody out the blue says your mom is a B, or, you know, something really, you know what I'm saying? Something really jacked up and directed toward, and you're hearing it, then all of a sudden you know, you're losing it or whatever. You know, maybe the fans should have been ejected as well. I mean, I'm
talking about somebody's mama. That is a bad play. And this is bad karma altogether, you know. He don't do that.
Right. You know what I'm saying? And the thing is, I mean, Beverly, he didn't do the right thing in escalating it. But I think there still should be some type of guidelines or something on the, you know, having a good time at, you know, watching your favorite team, but having, you know, at least some proper decorum if you're going to yell something. You know what I'm saying? Not everybody wants to hear, you know, a profanity-laced tirade. You know, there is respect. I'm just saying. Maybe that's just me.
Exactly, folks. We have a break coming up here. I want y'all to stick and stay with us. We're going to take us a nice little break here to get ready for emails. Keep sending your emails. This is the new email address, new website, info@bossmanshow.com. Repeat that. Emails, send them to the new Bossman Show website, bossmanshow.com. It's new, it's beautiful, it's pristine, it's great. This will be the first show posted on BossManShow.com. Be the FUR Report Holiday Special. Just so you all know, this special show. It's my first show that I ever did. So we're going to push this show up there first. It's to just show how much I care about this show for you guys. Email us at info@BossManShow.com. So we're going to take a break here, Hollywood. Listeners, live stream. We're going to come back after the break. Emails, Boston Hollywood on the Boss Man Show, 4:15, Boston Hollywood Holiday Special. We'll be back. Hold tight. We out.
And if you don't know, now you know, you know.
J.R. Smith, a lot of NBA FUIs, NF Cordarrelle, Patterson FUI. We've covered a lot. But now, it's hour two. It's episode of the Boss Hollywood Show, which means I turn up to our man, Hollywood Alex, to read the list of emails. I'm going to let Hollywood break down for you, listen, give y'all the disclaimer about what's going to happen the next 40 minutes on the Boss Man Show. Hollywood, it's on you, my brother. It's all you. I'll be going through emails as we on there with the live stream as we speak, brother.
Brother, I feel sorry for him right now. But anyway, here's the deal. We've basically made the show what it is from the FUI emails, which is a part and segment of our show, which are, I don't even know how to put it. They're mental cases in the making. But our fans, they send us email. And it kind of happened almost by accident. Where we were receiving email. Yeah, we were receiving emails to the show that were so bad. And I'm talking about as far as, you know, grammatical errors and talking about nonsense that we, I mean, I guess they wanted us to address on the show.
Yeah.
We just so we kind of made a thing of it, and it's lasted this long. And, like, surprisingly, you know, and we've been receiving more emails than ever, and they've only gotten worse.
Exactly.
And now it's like the thing to do. You know what I'm saying? We're going to send Hollywood Alec and the Boss Man these crazy emails, and we're going to watch him. We're going to listen to him read them over the air and struggle to get these emails out and to read them. And they probably think it's funny. You know, they're probably laughing when I read them. But I think it's pitiful.
Yes, it is. It shows us how effed up you are, not us. You.
Oh, dude. I'm just saying. I think it's ridiculous. You know. But because we appreciate our fans, I read them anyway. And I hope you all are ready because, you know, a lot of these emails that I'm about to read are not even really readable.
Not at all.
You know what I'm saying? And not only are they not readable, but a lot of them just don't even make logical sense. Like...
Sure
don't. I mean, they don't. You know, but it's been a tradition every quarter. And, you know, as pitiful as I think it is, I like doing it. I like reading them because I can only imagine the look on the faces of, you know, our FUI audience as they're listening to their own handiwork.
Exactly.
Well, so here it goes, man.
No doubt.
Here it goes. Email number one. Here we are. Sweet Willie Sugarloaf and Terrell P. News Source. Really? In the last week, WEAK. I was on the notepad to have an outing, witty female.
Oh, God.
This fool spelled female. Check this out. This fool spelled female, F-E-E hyphen M-A-I-L.
That's terrible.
Man, we was supplies to meet at Don Texaco Mexican Grill.
Oh, God.
She canceled on me due to a lime conclusion. A lime conclusion. Calling that here son, oh, wow, got in trouble a few weeks ago and that the molesting officer,
oh,
not arresting officer, the molesting officer was coming over to distance Sam thing. I don't buy it. Do you? Brian and Bowling Green. And do you? Do it spell D-E-W.
Oh, God.
Like he's about to do a commercial for a soda company or something.
Oh, God.
Mm-mm.
Brian's always bad.
Brian and Bowling Green. Brian, first of all, this right here, I mean, it's the first email and it's already went down here.
It went right to hell already.
I mean, I don't even know what you're talking about. You know what I'm saying? You, okay. You had an outing with a female. and you took her to a little restaurant, and she canceled because her son got in trouble. Okay. Well, looks like the officer is coming over to discuss her son getting in trouble.
I'm kind of with Briar in Hollywood.
Well, he's asking me if we buy it.
I don't buy it either because a detective would come over, not the arresting officer. I think, because she thinks Brian is the FUI, she had to find a way out from him, so she used that story. It could be true,
Yeah.
She had to use something Brian couldn't dispute to get him out of her life. She's like, oh no, he can't spell, he can't talk. I can't be seen with this guy. So I think it could be true, but I think that she used it to get out of the date with Brian too.
I'm just saying, if he got in trouble, I don't think an arresting officer would just be going over there to discuss something. Well, you know what I'm saying? They don't even say how old the kid is. You know, if it's a teenager, once he gets around, I can see if it was a child. You know what I'm saying? Like a young boy, but you know, if he's getting in trouble like that, there ain't no arresting officer coming over to discuss nothing with you.
He's discussing that activity probably. Hey, if you give me some of that, you know what, I might get your son off the hook. You know, it could be that discussion too.
Yeah,
and Brian got
That's a definite possibility.
And Brian got lost in the shuffle.
I'm coming over to discuss these issues with your son with a glass, with a bottle of Moscato. How about that? Favors. All right, here's our next listener email. Watch this. Okay. Ari and Leo.
Oh, God.
Hello, I'm a man. Well, thanks for letting us know that. And a period after I'm a man from another country. Period. Thanks for letting us know that. I am new to U.S. I am adjusting, but we're glad. I used to listen to show in old country. Oh, really? Great. I'm aware of the season of gifts. You must be talking about Christmas. Who do I give gifts to in country? Do women keep hair or... What? Do women keep hair or clothes hair?
What?
Are layers of linen worn or removed?
What?
Reboot and renovate me? Thank you, gentlemen. LB and Little Rock.
Wow.
I guess he owns a liquor store or something. I don't know.
That email is terrible.
Maybe a hair shop. I don't know.
His language was so broken, though, and so robotic in his language.
That fool said, reboot and renovate me.
What is that?
Hello. Hello. I'm a man from another country. I am new to U.S. I am adjusting. Yeah, it sounds like a robot.
Like, what is that?
Man, I'm moving on. All right, man. Okay, here, this. Oh, God, this is good. Joaquin and Julio Phoenix.
Wow.
First of all, who is that? That is not Boss Man in Hollywood. Really, Joaquin and Julio?
Terrible.
All right, dude. The woman... Here we go. The woman who I lay in bed is shopping too much. Woman uses my plastic to to shop things. Okay. Woman uses Turrentine electric act out to shop.
What?
Okay. Turrentine electric account to shop. Right. The bed is good, but shopping kill basket vibe.
Basket vibe?
I like to correct. Check this out. K-O-R-E-C-T. I like to correct it. Do you have rice to assist me, Joaquin and Julio? Delarian in Dallas.
Don't
yeah, that's what I was. I would expect that from somebody from Dallas, yeah.
Delarian.
He said, Delarian. He said, do you have rice to assist me? No, and I don't have mashed potatoes neither. I don't have gravy. I don't have meatloaf. None of that. Anyway, if she's spending your money like that, maybe you need to cut up the take the credit card or the bank card or whatever, or you know,
take your money out of the account, open up your own account, let her spend up her money, maybe.
Keep your cards to yourself. How about that? You buy her the gifts so you can monitor what you're buying her. You can monitor how your money's being spent. Okay, Delarian. Moving on. Oh, this ought to be good. Underground Greg and Buckle Siri.
What?
Man, look. This is preposterous. I met this woman on Instagram. We begin swapping words on Instagram. We also use video chat on Instagram.
That's awesome robotic talk again. That's that robotic talk again. I don't like that crap. That robotic talk thing.
For real, dude. I thought I was reading a bootleg Dr. Seuss book or something like that. I met this woman on Instagram. We begin swapping words on Instagram. We also use video chat on Instagram. Not here, not there, not anywhere. I do not like your eggs and ham. I do not like them in my ham.
This is terrible.
It's ridiculous. Things progress, not progress, to the point of date. The woman told me that it's a $500 fee. Deposit it for the date. What? Deposit for the date?
A date?
I ain't never heard of that before.
Me neither.
Oh my God. I tried to negotiate.
Oh God.
Come to through. He put the K-N-E-E. Negotiate with her.
Oh God.
It didn't go nowhere. I thought if I pay her $200... she might go for. I cash app $200 and she say $300 more and then we can schedule a date. She wouldn't give me my money back. Can I take her to Judge Mathis?
Oh, wow.
Ernie at Marshall. Yeah, you can take her to Judge Mathis. Cause I dude, I'm dying to hear how that's gonna go. Go ahead and do that. You know what I'm saying? We can supply you with the number and anything. I would love to see that on Judge Mathis. Because that would be awesome. I'm sure he'd give you a judgment.
Sir!
For real.
Sir, what is wrong with you? You actually fell for this, sir? Well, Judge, I mean, she said it, and I thought I could play her. She told you! It costs $500 to even date her, and you were short the fee, sir.
You, sir, are a certified nut.
Case dismissed. Maybe I'll go ahead and interview outside of the courtroom. Yeah, but I thought, you know, she's wrong for this. And I can see it right now.
Oh, my God. Yeah, so Ernie at Marshall's, yeah, take it to Judge Mathis. Look up the number. Get it. Do it. We'd love to see
I'm ready to get a pay. Hey, Hollywood, he's at Marshall's. If I had to get a payday loan, we stole out to all the rest of the payer, probably.
Pretty much. Pretty much. Oh my gosh. Okay. Yeah. Moving on. Walter in Hollywood. Wait a minute, man. Walter.
It's Walter.
At least you got my name right. That's a stretch. Okay. Check this out. I was privy to a stupid conversation in my workplace today where clowns were discussing curfews for their animals.
Oh, Lord.
Dogs. Thank you. Dogs and cats mostly, and taking pictures of them along with letting them in bed. Conversations like this is why I don't participate in potlucks, because I don't want an animal hair cuisine going down my throat.
Agreed.
How do you all feel about placing human things on animals and treating them like humans? Lester. How do you feel about that?
It's all right.
What do you feel about treating a human like an animal, or placing human things like what human things? I mean, are we talking about a skirt or some pants? Because, I mean, there are clothes that you can put on dogs. You know what I'm saying? But treating them like humans, like how? In what fashion? Allowing them to sleep in the bed? Like, God, I don't know. I have a cat, and the cat sometimes jumps in the bed. You know, it's not big enough for, you know, to make it. It's not as big as a dog or a big dog. You know, you see, you know, the commercials and stuff where the family, the husband and the wife wakes up and they have the big, humongous Cujo on top of the bed, chilling. You know what I'm saying? Like, I barely noticed that the cat is there. So I don't feel any real type of way about it. You know, I don't want no big ass dog in bed or nothing like that. I mean, what else does he mean? Treating them like humans? Letting them eat at the table?
I don't know what this guy...
Having a cigar and playing a card game? Like, what is...
Me giving them a curfew, maybe. Okay, how do you give an animal a curfew? Animals can't talk. I don't understand how you can give a dog or a cat a curfew.
Like, what are you supposed to do? Cujo, make sure you're inside when the light on the street, when the street light comes on. Make sure that you come back from your little date with the dog down the street at 9 o'clock. I don't know, you know what I'm saying? When the dog felt like coming in, like at my house, when we had a dog, the dog felt like coming in, we let the dog in. You know, it would wag its tail on the door, sound like somebody was knocking the door, we let him in. You know? And sometimes he would stay out all night. He just liked to be outside. So, I don't know. But it doesn't matter, Lester, because you're still an idiot. Okay. So now, we got another one. Mike and Max. Yeah, right. My son needs peasants for Christmas. He needs peasants? Well, first of all, we're not in medieval times, that's for sure. And number two... Who is Chris Mass? Who is that?
Oh, yeah.
My son needs peasants for Chris Mass. You're trying to say Christmas. You fell off. Can you spare radio cheese to help me pay for layaway stuff? Absolutely not.
Never.
I can't pay with cheese. We can't pay with lunch meat, french fries, nothing. Mom, baby, steal money via sun support, really. My money is low. Work at Liz. What? try to get a job at UPS. UPS is the box place. If you didn't help me out, Laquani in North Carolina.
Oh, God.
You're beyond help. If you didn't know, what is an internet? What? I'm not. No, you need to help yourself the best way you possibly can because you're a dingbat. Now here's a good one right here. This ought to be tough. Gamecock in Knight Edward.
Oh God,
it's over, dude. Knight Edward. Season 2 weeks later today. What? Season 2?
Jesus.
Season 2 weeks later today, and then we'll get back in time.
What?
And get back into town next Friday or Saturday or Friday. Let me try this again.
Terrible.
Okay. Season 2 weeks later today, and then we'll get back in time and get back into town next Friday or Saturday or Friday. We have to do it Wednesday, and Wednesday we have work for you guys, and then I'll probably be back around 4 tomorrow night or Saturday evening or whatever works best for you, and I will work together, and you will then go meet me up. And at least we'll get together for you guys tomorrow at my office or meet me at my desk. Charles at Raising Cane's.
Okay, where's a desk at Raising Cane's at? Where do you have a desk at Raising Cane's? I don't see a desk there when I go there.
Right, and number two, where did they hire people who send emails like that? Like,
oh my
God. That is borderline remedial. Like, dude.
That went nowhere.
I don't even know what he's trying to say.
What?
That fool said, I'll get back into town next Friday or Saturday or Friday. Which one is it? Sick of struggle.
I'm like, whoa.
Friday or Saturday or Friday, we have to do it. Wednesday and Wednesday, we have to work. Man, I'm too through.
I don't get what he's trying to say to us. I don't understand it.
Me neither. He was just, I guess he just felt like sending us an email. Well, Charles, man, I don't even know what to tell you, bro. You need help. That's drugs. Like, no more drugs, Charles at Raising Cane's. You know what I'm saying?
They didn't fire him immediately.
They pop a piss test on you, you're going to fail it, I'm sure. And then you're going to be back to what you were doing before you were working at Raising Cane's. You're probably staying at home with your parents or whatever. And sending us emails that we really don't want to read in the first place. You understand? Because that was difficult.
Sure, bird.
And I knew it would be. I knew it would be from the jump. Now, here's a good one. It's because it's short. Check this out. Daryl in Nailwood.
Wow.
I like a copy of Sucking Saucer. Can you pro-hide me with some? I like Wilson Pipes.
Oh, God.
He's good at fisting girls. Thanks, Ted at Ted. Thanks, Kevin at Ted Cobbler Hut.
Wilson
Pipes. What is that?
What is Ted Cobbler Hut? And do you mean Wesley Pipes, not Wilson Pipes?
Wilson Pipes. That's what he said. He's good at fisting girls. This dude is an idiot. I like a copy of Sucking Saucer.
I guess he was stocking stuff or maybe.
Oh my, I hope not.
I think that's what he wants.
I like a copy of Sucking Saucer. Gotcha. Okay, yeah. We'll send it to you. Look for it in the mail. Your Sucking Saucer with Wilson Pipes, who's good at fisting girls. Right. Check this out, man. Phone Style in Edwin Hollywood.
Whoa.
Yeah, this one's a genius. I'm mad. Well, get glad. Trick younger than me. Well, they usually are. Bought her friend on date with us. Expect me to pay for friend. Hell now. What? I walk out. Young Trick don't understand why I walk out. She's stupid. Why she do that? Where Young Trick come up with that? I'm done with her. Marcus at Kia.
Does he mean Kia?
That fool said Kia. K-E-Y-A.
These fools are out of control and out of line right now.
It is ridiculous. Okay. She brought the young Trick he's dating brought a friend on a date with him and expected him to pay for the friend. Well, and he walked out, and the young Trick didn't understand why he walked out. Okay, first of all, the question is, who is the friend?
Exactly.
Okay. Now, she brought a female, because we can't just specify, we can't just assume that she brought a female. She could have brought somebody who she said was her dude friend. And if that was the case, you had every right to walk out.
Mm-hmm.
And number two, if she brought a friend who was a chick, I mean, I'd be thinking, how does this chick look? What's she working with?
Exactly.
Because, you know, maybe things will transpire. If you catch my drift. Might be worth paying for the dinner. Especially if you're dealing with a young Trick. So Marcus at Kia, I think you might have jumped the gun. But doesn't matter. Want to know why? Because you're still an imbecile, you're still an FUI, and we're moving on. All right. Sean Malone and Kevon Curry.
Oh, God.
Sean Malone and Kevon Curry.
Terrible.
I held, dude. This, it gets worse. I held to cut. Oh God. I held to cut to off lady. I like that.
Oh God.
What? She brought. She bought her four kids on the calendar we was on.
What do you mean date?
That fool said he bought her four kids on the calendar we was on. I'm ready to give it up right there. She bad to be with four kids, but I calendar with her. She tell me she don't have no kids sitting. I don't want to be buying four kids on calendar. I want to calendar with her. You idiot. I cut off her by no conversation. She tell me I pie tie. What? I pie tie. Okay.
Maybe petty,
what
maybe?
You think? What?
If she says he's petty, maybe.
I pity.
Well, petty. He's petty for not going through with this horrible date.
That dude said pie tie. I pie tie. What you think? Santana. Well, Santana, I think that you are borderline remedial. And that you need riff. That's what I think. Reading is fundamental.
You're an imbecile, Santana. That's what you are. He's being nice. You're an imbecile, Santana.
Yeah, this dude is an idiot. Like, for real, dude. Like, You call a date a calendar? I mean, okay, forget the fact, you know what I'm saying? All right, I see what you're saying. You know, she's bringing her four kids. I'm not even on that. I'm on you calling a date a calendar. You're an idiot. You are an idiot. Don't write us no more.
Yeah.
Just don't do it.
Don't do it ever again, Santana, please.
Don't do it. All right, man, we moving on, okay? Because, yeah. Yeah, that sent me off, dude. That was ridiculous. Okay, Johnny and Andrew Hall of Wood. Idiot. Anyway, I'd like Crouch licked by Cortuit Patterson?
What? She can't get the man name right from last segment. Oh, God.
Is he talking about that dude, what's his name?
Yeah, Corduroy. Cordero, whatever. Whatever his name is.
Coca-Cola.
Yeah, that guy.
I don't mind it. I'm a designer at Envy Hair Studio. Darlene.
It's a chick.
Pepper, please. Straight F-U-I. I'm sure you wouldn't mind. I like Crouch Lick. What the heck, guys? Anyway, this is good. Idiomatic Punchline and Summer Wilson.
Oh, God.
Idiomatic Punchline and Summer Wilson.
How do you come up with that name?
I don't know, man. Geez. Is a Goodwill a good place to buy holiday gifts? Can the show me with a gift cert, Tiffany. Tiffany Kate? What? Can the show help me with a gift cert, Tiffany? Anyway.
Certificate. Oh, God.
This fool said gift cert, Tiffany Kate. I need the electrician money for a fight. Jimmy at Church of Alabama. Church of Alabama? There's a Church of Alabama?
Yes, it is. Wow.
So, you mean to tell me there's a church where they worship a country group?
Oh, man.
I'm too through. I'm too through. Oh. Oh, could this be it? Could this be my Christmas gift?
It could be.
You're not going to believe this one. I don't believe it now. Check this out. Boss in Hollywood. I like the way that sounds. Boss in Hollywood. I love the show. You guys make me laugh. I always learn something when I listen to the show. And I don't want to harass you with all my questions, but... Oh, no. I don't want to harass you with all my questions... But I miss when you all were weekly. Can you all do that again? Valencia at Macy's. Well, you never know. Right now, with all my business ventures, that doesn't seem likely. But you never know. You know, we like doing it quarterly. We kind of gives the fans a chance to miss us and build up our material.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? But plus, it fits really good into my schedule. But, just like I said, you never know. We used to do it weekly at one time. You know, you never know. You know what I'm saying? I never say never. But thank you for your question, Valencia at Macy's.
Actually, a good email, finally.
I was actually going to say, in a sea of FUIs, she's a diamond in the rough.
Exactly.
Like, in a sea of FUI activity, there is one small beacon of light, and that is Valencia at Macy's. Exactly. Absolutely awesome. Absolutely awesome. That made my day. But now it's back to the shenanigans. Okay? Cyber and Acrobat Mike. I knew it was going to go downhill from somewhere. brought us to a high point, right back to the low point, right back to a low point.
Exactly.
All right. I need a new iPhone and website. You all got the money. Bless me. It's holiday season. Alicia Slick in Chicago. Well, let me tell you something, Alicia Slick in Chicago.
Hell no.
You understand? You might need an iPhone and a website, but I want you to bless me. Now, go figure that out, third grade education. All right. That's for Alicia Slick in Chicago.
I got one more.
You want a blessing? Hey, you want a blessing? We want a blessing, too.
This guy's an idiot.
How about that?
I sent you an email. This guy's an idiot.
Oh, my God. Unbelievable. Alicia Slick bring a bad name to my home city. All right. Okay, here we go. Martinez in mourning. Really? Martinez in mourning. It's cold outside. Can you buy me a cold? What kind of an idiot are you?
What does that even mean?
Can you buy me a cold? I wish I could. I wish I could buy you some salmonella, too.
Oh, my goodness.
That would be fun. Buy you a nice dose of the salmonella. How about that? Send it first. Send it priority mail. With a pipe and an ascot.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So you can be sick in style.
Now, Hollywood, this is the last email segment. What is your take on this quarter four batch of emails tonight?
They were horrible. They were horrible. They were exactly what they were supposed to be. Absolutely deplorable. Except the one from Valencia at Macy's. And you know what's funny? I know a couple of Valencias. A couple. And they're both good looking. So I can almost imagine.
And they're not FUIs like these people who email the show. But Valencia from Macy's is very smart and attractive.
Yes. At Macy's. Makes me want to go to Macy's.
No, that price is high as hell, but.
Yeah. But I, you know, I've. Especially out here. Like when I have went to Macy's, you know what I'm saying? Like, as far as shopping, maybe with my mom, my mother-in-law, because they like going there. I've never seen somebody busted working at Macy's. Have you?
Nope.
Like, I'm serious. I've never seen anybody busted working at Macy's.
I haven't either.
You know what I'm saying? She's got to be some kind of smart. I mean, she. Look at that email is like
pristine.
Elegance
and class.
It's like the lighting of a match in a pitch black hallway. You know how you kind of get that sigh of relief because you're out of the darkness? It's like, finally, I can see something.
We've reached somebody.
And I can see somebody has a brain. Huh?
We finally reached somebody. Finally.
You understand? Finally, and that's rare. Like, we don't get perfect emails, so that's rare. So she can send another one. She can continue to email us, but Alicia Slick, yeah, you gotta go. You're a dingbat. And Jimmy at Church of Alabama, that was funny. You're an idiot. Who else? Darlene, you need your behind whoop. Santana, forget about it. Marcus at Kia, you're a dingbat. Kevin at Ted Cobbler Hut, I don't even know what the hell that is. You're an even bigger idiot. Okay? Charles at Raising Cane's, you need to learn how to read. Laquani in North Carolina, that's not even a place. not even a place. Like, what the hell, North Carolina?
Exactly.
You're an embarrassment. Lester, you're dumb. Ernie at Marshall's. If you ever get in touch with the Judge Mathis Show, please send us an email.
Please.
We'd like to see where that goes. We'd love to see where that goes. Because I can only imagine, because you're a dingbat. Delarian in Dallas, your name tells us everything we need to know about you.
Yes, indeed.
Okay. LB and Little Rock give me some. You can give me a bottle of Cisco, some breath mints, and some extra large condoms.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Put it on my car. Brian in Bowling Green, do you? Whether it's Mountain Dew, whether it's doo doo,
just do you.
I mean, you calling you with a Sweet Willie Sugarloaf and Terrell P. News Source, that was the epitome of ridiculousness.
Exactly.
That fool said Sweet Willie Sugarloaf.
Pathetic.
Unbelievable.
Pathetic.
Yeah, pathetic. Pathetic.
Well, folks.
Come on, man.
That's emails.
What do you got to say about these ones, man?
They were out of control. And you did what you did, listeners. You emailed us. You showing us love. We needed the show. And so, folks, hang tight. Got a break. Boston Hollywood segment coming up after the break. Y'all chill. We'll be back.
Oh, wow.
More material after the break. We out.
And if you don't know, now you know.